For the past couple of months, I've been developing a bit of an obsession with sourdough bread. There's something about the magic of turning flour, salt, and water into a delicious loaf of bread that has me, and now a lot of my friends, completely hooked. The big intrigue of sourdough, though, is, of course, the starter. I feed mine religiously every morning, but I really have no idea what it is. I put blind faith in it every time I want to bake a loaf of bread that it'll turn out, but I really want to know what's actually happening in a sourdough starter. I'm a PhD student, and I'm going to look into this the same way I would with my own research, with, of course, a literature review. And wow, for someone coming from a material science background, sourdough science is way over my head. From my understanding, the sourdough starter can be broken into two main players, the yeast and the bacteria. The bacteria are of the Lactobacillus genus, where a genus is just a group of a bunch of different species. These bacteria are called lactic acid bacteria, which scientists nickname lab. A common species of the more than 50 species that scientists have found present in different starters from all over the world is Lactobacillus senfrancisensis. Try to say that 5 times fast. These bacteria feed on sugar and produce lactic acid, acetic acid, a bit of CO2, and sometimes ethanol. This acidic environment is what's responsible for the slight tartness of sourdough, and is also what keeps bad bacteria from spoiling the dough while it's fermenting. It's also important for improving the bioavailability of important minerals like calcium, magnesium, and iron by decreasing the phytate content of the bread. This is important because phytic acid, in addition to being a pretty complicated looking compound, is highly charged, meaning it's very reactive. It's so reactive that it'll actually attach to the minerals in the bread instead of letting them become absorbed by the body. So it's essentially stealing our food. But thankfully, there's enough bacteria to take care of that. In fact, there are a lot of organisms in a sourdough starter. In just 1 gram, there are 1 to 3 billion colony-forming units, or CFU, of bacteria, and 1 to 50 million of the other very important player, yeast. Wild yeast, which is naturally present all around us, in the air and on our hands, thrives in the acidic environment that the lactic acid bacteria produce. The yeasts are of the Saccharomyces and Candida genuses, with more than 25 different species. During fermentation, these single-celled fungi break down the starch in the flour into sugar, giving off carbon dioxide and ethanol. Now that we have that out of the way, it's time to bake a loaf of bread. The first part of sourdough baking is making sure you have a good starter. You want to feed your starter regularly, once a day if you leave it on the counter, and once a week in the fridge. Feeding the starter is easy. Just add equal parts by weight, water, and flour, mix, and let sit for a couple of hours to let the yeast and bacteria eat the meal you just gave them. After you have a healthy starter, it's time to bake some bread.
Here's how I make mine.
I take 400 grams of flour and mix it with 6 grams of salt. Then I add 160 grams of my sourdough starter and 230 grams of water. I mix that until combined and then roll it out on the counter and knead for around 10 minutes. Then I plop it back into the bowl and mix everything in. Cover it and let it rise for 3 to 4 hours. After that first proof, I pour it out on the counter again, form it into a loaf shape, put it into a well-floured proofing basket, and then into the fridge overnight. When I take it out the next morning, I roll the loaf out of its basket, score it, put it in a preheated Dutch oven at 475 degrees Fahrenheit for 40 minutes, taking off the lid for the final 20 minutes. I then let it sit for as long as I can manage before digging in.
I think it's safe to say I've become a little obsessed with baking sourdough over the past couple of months. Just baking it is fun, but learning about the science behind it is kind of addictive.
It's genuinely fascinating to realize that something as simple as baking a loaf of bread involves complex processes that scientists have dedicated their lives to studying. So, if you're interested in learning more about the basic science of everyday things, maybe stick around. I'll be making these episodes as frequently as I can. I'm working on the next one now, and I think it's going to be a good one. Any guesses?